I'm very glad to be here today, so I can actually give a little bit more insight and share what modular housing actually means. I could also talk for hours about architecture because I am an architect, but the focus is modular housing today. Also understand that most of you are in this area of developer, state agents, architects, and also, so I'm sure everyone has some understanding of it. But when people come to our show house, I noticed that a lot of people do not really know what it means. And that is what they really think. It's called a Lego house, the panels are in the factory, all they do, stacked up the panels, put them together, and that's it. The truth is a very different one. It's much more complicated, much more sophisticated, and especially what Hufhaus does. Because Hufhaus has started with model homes, house 1, 2, 3, but now everything is bespoke. So not only do you have the challenge of having clients every single day, you have a factory there, you need to bring them together. And also what a lot of people underestimate is this. There's a very long heritage. You do not make a house in that kind of sophisticated level in one generation. The know-how has accumulated. Now I am the third generation and the fourth already in the family business. And it started with my grandfather in 1912 with a sawmill. So that's where the passion of timber already started. And at that time, until today, you have to be a master, otherwise you couldn't train and employ people. So my dad started 1960 with the idea, okay, let's do housing. He has architects, but you can see already, this one here is very contemporary. He always was keen to hire architects who are ahead of themselves. And the breakthrough was 1972. That's where he decided to meet an architect, loved the post and beam. He said, that is the future. No market research, no nothing. But he felt, this is how I think a house should look like. Lots of glass and timber. So that was a breakthrough. He got away with doing house 1, 2, 3 for, let's say, 10 years. And then it stopped because the client said, and I want a bespoke home. Now we get into the inside of how the factory looks inside, actually. You will see a lot of machines, CNN machines, but at the same time, it's very important to highlight. It's a combination of know-how, traditional craftsmanship, and high-tech precision. And that's how it starts. The components are made first, and each house is individually ordered, own list of materials, and we can see already on the post, each post has a different look, different work at it. The waste that's happening is recycled, will be used for heating up the factory on the right-hand side, and at the same time, if it's more than you need, it's been sold to people who are doing particle boards or other composite panels. And here we see now how a panel looks like, but custom-made components. Now these people know what they are doing. Roughly speaking, on one house, circa 200 people work 1 week, and then it's done. But you can imagine the preparation to do this. It's quite high. On the left side, you see a roof with a very custom-made velux. On the right-hand side, the wall is ready to go, hanging off, and you see already there's a door already in it, painted, does not need to be touched anymore. The level of pre-manufacturing is extremely high at Hufhaus. There are many other companies who are doing pre-manufacture, but not to that high level of pre-manufacturing. And a lot of people also underestimate, there are a lot of smaller bits, and one of the trademarks of Hufhaus is the installation wall. You see here in the middle, the toilet is already part of the wall. The pipes are already in. That wall is just added to another wall. That means the sound is not transferred, and the plumber knows exactly that's where the toilet goes and the sinks. There's no other choice. It's clearly defined, because we already know the tiles are that long, they don't need to be cut. Now, clearly, these are the main benefits, controlled environment. You don't have any rain, no sun, no wind. It's a perfect situation to build a proper house. Next feature, quality control. Hufhaus knows exactly what goes in, and they know exactly what is leaving the factory. And then a massive big issue is training. 20% of the workforce are apprentices, and it will be supervised 24 hours a day. Of course, you have different trades. You have plumber, you have a carpenter, you have a cabinet maker, all under one roof. That's the feature, therefore optimized logistics. And then, of course, recycle has always been important, but even more important now, because waste is an issue we should treat very carefully. And that is a very important subject now. Everyone thinks, okay, modular housing, it must be cheap, fast, let's save some money. That's what Hoovers is not doing. This is not a cheap investment, not a cheap house. The reason why Hoovers does it, because they are passionate for quality. And if you would do this traditional way, you pay twice as much for that quality. That's why it's cost effective. And last but not least, that's what the client prefers, turnkey, from the very beginning to the very end, all under one roof. And that's what they prefer, having that service from the beginning, as we heard at the very beginning. Service is for us the key. This is what you don't want. Water is the biggest enemy on the building site. That's why Hoovers wants to hurry up and build the house. I'll show you in a second how fast they are. You don't want the insulation wet. Now I show you a very quick time lapse, sorry, how a house is being built, and that's right now the sample of a show house. So you get the juice out of it. Overall, it took 2 weeks to make it watertight, like that. Yeah. So now, of course, it looks simple. But I heard someone who said, if you have a ballet dancer smiling, that's hard work. That's exactly the same thing. Now I show you what the design is about a little bit and the variety, because a lot of people think, oh, there is no variation, it's just one house. The opposite. This is my house, designed that 10 years ago, and it's a very typical Hoof trademark. The entire facade is glass. Massive challenge because we have a high wind load in this island. So to make sure it doesn't fall apart, you have to be very good engineers. And a traditional roof. This is a very different house. This is an upside down house. Bedrooms are downstairs, it's on a slope, kitchen, dining, lounge upstairs, and a lot of people call this the butterfly. The Hoovers got very famous for. Client asked me to design, and they came right away from an architectural book, I didn't insist on a flat roof design. So that's what I did. With an integrated pool, three-car garage, and a basement. Hoovers has also the same way a basement they do the house upstairs. And this is very high density. This is in Kingston, three-story townhouse. This is the latest, I'll show you later on a video clip what Hoovers done. This is the first house ever, just timber and glass, including interior walls. So Hoovers has sorted out to stiffen out the building without steel in the wall. They have now figured out the glass is so strong, triple glazed, it can take the wind. So they have invented some special connectors. The patent is on the way right now. And once it's proven and tested, they will implement it, I would guess, another half a year. This I like a lot. People now probably understand where it comes from. It's old and new. It fits very well in old Tudor-style house. As well, this is here, 300-year-old cottage. The client asked me to add a one-story extension. They loved it. And that shows you the variety. Hoovers does not only houses. This is in Germany. Does apartments there, 40 units in the dense area, as well as large offices. So you see the flexibility is endless. And I would love to talk about architecture, but I don't, because it is quite an exciting subject and takes too long. I want to call a little bit now because people want to have a little bit more, what is Hoovers actually innovative about? And that's what we are very keen. We always use the best materials we find our hands on, triple glazing, Clulam timber, very sophisticated timber. And therefore, you have extreme good view values and the air tightness is second to none. Energy efficient design, everyone talks about it, Hoovers has it on the agenda for the last 20 years. Sustainable materials, timber is, in our opinion, the best material to build a house of. We are using the solar heat gain the glass gives you. We also have a very generous roof overhang because nowadays, when you have a lot of glass, you need to watch out the house gets not too hot because it will take energy to get rid of it. So generous roof overhang, outside blinds, minimizes the overheating. And last but not least, renewable energy sources is a key right now. Hofhaus is now, since 7 years, using heat pumps, the only source for energy. And also, always been standard for Hof, but let's say there is a house being built, any packaging goes back to the factory, and no fire on site. And then last but not least, since 8 years, Hofhaus to be heated does not need any fossil fuel, no gas, no oil. So when people build a house, and typically are in the countryside, typically the house we do are replacement dwellings for private clients. They don't need an additional gas pipe. They use just the heat pump. And here we can see a little bit of content. I'm not boring you, do it in 5 seconds. Red shows you what you get away with here in the building regulations currently. Green is what Hofhaus performs at. And two items stand out. As smaller the number, as better it is, the U value of external glazing is at Hofhaus 0.4, and you get away with 2.0. So it's not only twice as good, it's 4 times better. The air tightness you get away in this country, the average is 6-7. You get away with 10, Hofhaus is at 1. Therefore, one of the most sustainable houses you can imagine, and everyone is envying me, saying, Peter, how is it possible to boost that much glass? Well, we've done our homework. You can. And that's where Hofhaus has a passion, is the light in the house. And that results in lots of certificates, international, in Germany, excellence in solar energy, plus energy house from Fraunhofer Institute in Stuttgart, Switzerland, excellence in sustainable and energy efficiency, and the last one here we got from the German Sustainability Chamber, saying that every Hofhaus that is leaving the factory is already gold standard. You can go further, but then you have to do locally a little bit more. And here, these are the awards I received when I started here 20 years ago. The first 2000 already best energy saving home. Then my house got the commendation of environmental sustainability. And as everyone knows, there was a long talk about code level 6. Hofhaus achieved it, but then it got basically not anymore. It's now in a different setting. And we also got a compliment from Kingston enhancing the townscape. Business-wise, my brother decided to turnkey service to the client. So, once you have a house, why not doing him the furniture? Why not doing the basement? Why not doing the garden? Why not doing the foundation? So, and that's the service package, which I also totally agree with you, that it's the key, because our clients are very demanding clients. And you only can do that if you have your product in order. So, and the last slide is a little bit of a clip where I do show you a little bit of what the future entails. Because Hofhaus is not only sitting on building materials, it's also what is artificial intelligence doing for us now. And you're not in 10 years' time, it's already available now. And this house has been developed together with IBM for the last half a year. And my dad is still alive. They use him to show what this house can do, and the clip should hopefully talk for itself.
Hello, Pippa. Die Musik an meinem 19. Geburtstag hat mir aber besser gefallen.
Ja, hallo Opa. Hier ist der Alex, grüß dich.
Hallo.
Wir warten auf dich hier, die Pressekonferenz hat schon längst angefangen.
Ja, ich bin aber noch im neuen Musterhaus.
Ah, okay, soll ich dich abholen oder?
Nein, der Pepper bringt mich doch. No, you don't
need to. Okay, der Pepper bringt dich. Alles klar, dann bis gleich, ciao.
That is the future. So, that's a surface presentation of so much more to do. If anybody has a question, I'm happy to answer now or later on. Thank you.